Inhabitants in parts of the Ashanti region have recently complained about unstable power supply to their homes and places of business after the situation persisted in some areas in the beginning of this year. Angry customers either resorted to social or traditional media to vent their frustration. The power distribution company ECG dispelled assertions that the country was going back to its dreaded days, which was christened Dumso. Although there has been significant improvement in power supply in the region, authorities of the company have outlined measures to make boost supply. Managing Director of the Electricity Company of Ghana, Kwame Ajiman Budu, spoke about some interventions
to mitigate all these challenges. In our area here in Ashanti region, we are trying to construct a primary substation at Agogo area, which will link Konongo, Agogo, and Jusso together so that we have a stable service. On that note, we have spent about 15 million Ghana cedis to reinforce the system or our network. In the medium term, we try to pump in 29.5 million cedis also to strengthen the network to make sure we have a reliable and stable service. We've also found out how and why all these outages always prevail. We come to realize that there are some old transformers that need to be changed, cables, relays, reclosures, sectionalizers, and all other things. To mitigate this, we try as much as possible to replace most of them. Especially the jumper card is something that is frequently hurting us.
The Ashanti Strategic Business Unit has a customer population of 949,435. With a total of 5,421 distribution transformers. The unit says it is undertaking some projects to ensure reliability, power delivery, and safety in the region. Despite these interventions, authorities are still worried about power theft issues.
We've also come to realize that during illegal connections, some of us, trying to steal power from us, make our transformers overloaded. In our system, we know how many people are on each transformer, but for somebody doing illegal, will be on the blind side of us, so it will overload the transformers, and many a times, overload the transformer trip the feeder and causing outages. We are trying to mitigate all this. We are also putting in place a mechanism whereby fault detectors are easy. In our current situation, to detect fault is like trial and error. We don't have a system whereby it can pinpoint the exact location, especially when it comes to an underground cable. Even though we have a test van, the test van has to go to trial before it identifies. But we are trying to implement a new system called VIT, whereby you can sectionalize a portion of the where the fault is. Instead of the whole line going off, you can sectionalize the portion and just close the other end so that the other people on the other end can get service. We have put measures in place to make sure the service is stable and consistent.